Hello and welcome to this Devlog on creating fix wiring tasks from Among Us in 3D in Unity. To start with, Among Us is a very accessible and very popular game that you have probably already heard of, and if you played it, you are very likely to have stumbled upon the fix wiring task. Briefly, in Among Us, you are a crew member trying to fix up a damaged spaceship while having some imposters looking for your death. And one of the tasks in Among Us is fix wiring task. In this one, you need to connect the wires with correct color and fix electric panels in several locations in a game lifetime. When I play games, I really think about how they could be recreated in Unity, and I generally opt for 3D develop and thought how could fix wiring be translated to a 3D mechanic. Product of this thought concluded here. In this video, I will be breaking down the fix wiring task as a mechanic and go through the steps and thought process of cloning it to 3D. First, let's start with the game. At the start, we see 4 wire cuts in the left side and 4 ends on the right side. Wires on the left are interactable with mouse or touch drag. When it is released, somewhere in the middle, it returns to its initial position immediately. When a wire is dragged far enough to the other side, it connects with the closest wire cut. When mouse released, the wire end stays there. To move the wire end out of the connection, the mouse should be dragged for some distance. Then the wire returns to the mouse position. If a wire connected with a correct wire end, there is a yellow light lighted up, representing electric currents. If connected pair is wrong, no light changes. And more than one wire could connect to the same wire end. Lastly, when all wires are connected correctly, the task finishes. This was how this mechanic could be broken down for me. Before diving deep into the implementation approach, I want to give a small environment heads up. Inside wires, I am modeling attempt from a developer in 3ds Max, and all the parts are either built in Unity objects or modeled with ProBuilder in Unity. Now we can continue with the core part of this video, recreating the fixed wiring task. While creating this, I divided the development in 2 parts. First, move the wires with mouse drag. Second, create a match system. This was a very big part, I should say. Moving the wires is kind of straightforward. There is a scaled object between 2 transform positions, and the scaled object's main transform properties, position, rotation, and scale is changed with each update regarding the other 2's transform. Wires are octagonal prisms created with ProBuilder, and the wire ends, looking very like pencils, I was told my sister, are also created within Unity using ProBuilder. The wire is connected to a fixed transform on the left side, and the position of the cut wire on the other side. Cut wire is dragged by the mouse, and the middle wire is scaled, moved, and rotated in each update. It is scaled as the distance between 2 pivots, placed in the middle point of 2 pivots, and lastly rotated such as its y-axis will be parallel to the direction starting from end wire to cut wire. While moving the cut wire, it also gets rotated towards the same direction, so it will always be pointing at the mouse position. While doing this, I have created 2 videos on scaling 3D objects. First one is on scaling a 3D object from both sides, and the other one is on scaling objects by mouse position from a fixed start point. If you want to have a deeper technical implementation of this in Unity, you can check them out. I will be leaving the links in the description. Now, the match system. If you don't count the intersecting 3D cables, this works just fine as in Among Us. A match entity, this rope, holds the information from both sides, and with virtual communication, it detects whether there's a match or not on the rope. Mainly, a match rope consists of non-moving wire ends, moving wire cut on the left side, non-moving cut on the right side, an invisible port for snapping wire cut, and a connection feedback light on the right side. Wire scaled between the movable wire cut and the transform placeholder, very close to the end of the fixed wire. When a wire cut collides with a collision detector port on the right side, it snaps to its position and gets connected to the other wire end. There are rectangle lamps showing the electric currents. Since the electricity is coming from the left side, they are all yellow. On the contrary, on the right side, they are all turned off. Dark gray state at the start. If correct objects match, they light up as well. Here, collision port informs the match entity whether a wire cut entered to or exited from a collision with it. From the wire cut reference and exit center state, the match entity informs current light and the match system manager. And for the match system manager, It is mainly responsible for spawning randomly colored match rows and mixing their places. It takes a material list and wire count, then spawns the wires and distributes the colors. Material lists are stored in secret pool objects, so at the same time I can have a list of materials from default colors and the player colors ready and saved. For example, if you ever get bored of default colors, you could play with player colors with more than 4 wires. As a side responsibility, it holds the correct match count in the wall system and informs the developer with debug messages. When everything is correct, we get a very hard type message. Then you go and destroy the solution, then get another one, and once again. I think this part is very open to being connected to your interface. Let me know if you're interested in that. Like the previous step, I have also created a tutorial on creating a 3D match system in Unity, where the object's responsibilities are broken down in more details and the implementation is explained for each one. I will be leaving the link. With that, we created a 3D fixed wiring task clone in Unity. I have been eyeing some more tasks from Among Us to recreate in 3D in Unity, so please let me know what you thought of this one, and maybe a next one will come. I enjoyed creating this project and hope you also enjoyed watching this breakdown. If you like this video, please give it a like and subscribe for the next one. That's it for now, I hope to see you in the next explorations, and bye bye!